Okay, so this is a problem I encountered when I was testing. And what I did with this was I edited a file in this directory called GCC specs, and you can remove this W error flag, and that allows it to be built. It says we shouldn't run a test there, so we'll just install it. Now, as the same with the EFI file, there's a new version, I believe. I can't remember what version it was now. 16, I think it was. So let's see if we can grab this. Yeah, there it is. Okay, yeah, this is another problem I had. And what it's saying, it needs this variable to be set to the location of the EFI directory partition. So all we need to do here is to add in EFI dir equals and then the location, which is boot. EFI, I think it was. So now we should be able to install. Install source. Right, yeah, this installs the binary and that installs the man page. So there was a problem with this link. The layout of the file structure has changed. So I'm going to have to navigate that one. Let's do this one here. So it was in unifont, font builds unifont. So unifont, yeah, see it's no unifont builds now, it's just straight into whatever version is the latest, and looks like that one, August 12.103. And we want something that looks like unifont dash version dot pcf dot gz. Font builds. Yeah, it looks like it could be that one. Unifont dash version dash PCFGZ. PCFGZ, yeah. That's that one there then. Oh, right, okay, yeah, there's something different to do with this. Yeah, it's not a tarball. So we need to do these commands to create a directory. and then it actually gets unzipped. And the output of that goes to that file there. Let's just check this because there's a problem when I was testing this. Yeah, it looks okay. So now we need to install grub by the looks of it. Is that something that's still outstanding to do? No, it's just using it because we've already installed it, so we need to reinstall it with these new options. So let's unzip it again. I forgot to remove the directory from last time. So I think all of these can be added. So let's run the what's happening there. That's strange. That's I bet there's tabs in this. That's probably because it seems to be listing the files and the directories. There must be some tab characters hidden within this document. So let's copy this a line at a time. So it says the optional dependencies are installed, configure should output the following. So I just got to check for those at the end because we've selected those. So grub mk font is yes, that's okay. Build time grub mk font, yep. And with unifont from user share fonts, unifont, unifont PCF, which is there, so that's okay. So I'll just build that. So if the LFS system is booted from the LFS plus the hints grub, which is what we've just done, it doesn't appear to know about Linux EFI attributes. So using Linux path to kernel then. So that's the standard way of starting the command, so that's okay. Unless you have the EFIs. Okay, so there's just some kernel options next, which we need to look at in association with the ones for DOS tools. So Let's go back to chapter 8 now and just finish up here. So let's tidy that up. So we need to add in the root, which is online. It's ZD. What have I done? ZD0P3, and it's just 4, and the swap is ZD0P2. And I need one for the boot partition. Auto, so it doesn't get mounted automatically.